Good morning to all. In the last classes, we discussed about the power amplifiers, class A power amplifiers, so and so. Okay, today I would like to explain class A push-pull power amplifier. So, in class A amplifier, the cue point must be midway on the load line, okay, center of the load line. In class B push-pull, the cue point on the x-axis. In class A, center of the load line. In class B push-pull, the cue point is on the x-axis. Okay. So, hence to bring it to midpoint, instead of grounding the center tap of the input transformer, an external battery is added in between center tap of the input transformer and the ground. Okay, so in this, the comparison of the with the class B, both the transistors Q1 and Q2 will conduct for both the off cycles of the input due to external biasing. Hence, output power will be also double compared to the class B version. So, in this push-pull amplifier, the crossover distortion is introduced. In this, for transistor to be in active region means base emitter junction must be forward biased and collector base junction is reverse biased. So, for a transistor is to be active region, the base emitter junction must be forward biased. The junction cannot be made forward biased till the voltage applied greater than the cut-in voltage. Cut-in voltage, how much? In silicon cut-in voltage is 0.7. In germanium cut-in voltage is 0.3. So, generally 0.7 volts per silicon and 0.2 or 0.3 volts per germanium transistors. Hence, as long as the magnitude of the input signal is less than the cut-in voltage of the base emitter junction, the collector current remains zero and transistor remains in the cutoff region. Okay. In this class A push-pull amplifiers, both the transistors, the two transistors T1 and T2 are used. The two transistors emitters are connected. Okay. First transistor emitter is connected to the second transistor emitter. So, the input is applied to the two inputs through the center tap transformer. So, this is the center tap. Okay. So, in this two transistors are used, two transistors and two transformers are used. Okay. So, center tap transformer is used. The transformer in center tap, so it provides opposite polarity signals to the two transistor inputs. So the two transistors Q1 and Q2 carry the DC components. Okay, DC components of the collector current ICQ. In this, these currents are equal to the magnitude and flow in opposite direction through the primary of the transformer T2. So, there is practically no net DC power output which is obtained by the single transformer. So, in this class A push-pull amplifier, crossover distortion is introduced. So, such a distortion in the output signal is called the crossover distortion. Class A crossover distortion. Due to crossover distortion, each transistor conducts less than the off cycle. okay, only it conducts less than the half cycle rather than the complete half cycle. Only less than the half cycle it will be conducted. The part of the input cycles for which two transistors conduct alternatively, okay, the crossover distortion in common in both the types of class B amplifiers. So how it is eliminated, crossover distortion? To eliminate the crossover distortion, some modifications are necessary in the basic circuits of the class B amplifiers. The basic reason for the crossover distortion is that cut-in voltage of the junction transistor, cut-in voltage, okay. So to overcome this cut-in voltage, a small forwarded bias is applied to the transistors. Let us see the practical circuits used to apply the such forward bias in the two types of class B amplifiers. Okay, so that is the push pull and complementary symmetry amplifier. So in this harmonic distortion in class A push pull amplifier is D equal to square root of D2 square plus D5 square plus D3 square plus D5 square plus D7 square, only odd harmonics. So advantages and disadvantages. In push pull amplifiers only two identical transistors are used. So in this, so identical transistors, both are NPN transistors. That is the disadvantage. And a center tap transforming is required in transformers, center tap transform. So transformers used are bulky and expensive. So we are using two transformers, so expensive and bulky also. And advantages, sir, even harmonics are absent in the output. And high DC output power is obtained. So, and the next one, class B amplifier. So, class A is completed. And the next one, class B. So, in this class B, Q point is main. Q point is main. So in this class B amplifier, Q point on the x-axis, in this, okay, center in class A amplifiers, but Q point is in the x-axis. The transistors remains in the active region only for positive of cycle of the input signal. Hence this positive of cycle is reproduced at the output. For negative of input cycle, the transistor enters into the cutoff region and no output is produced. Okay, only positive of cycle is conducted. Negative of cycle is enters into the cutoff region, so no output. Only positive of cycle is the input. So 180 degrees. So collector current flows only in 180 degrees. Both of cycles are 360 degrees. But only positive of cycle will conduct. Negative of cycle is cutoff region. So no output. So only one of cycle means 180 degrees phase shift. So the collector current flows only 180 degrees of the input signal. So only half cycle is obtained at the output. For full input cycle, the output signal is distorted. So the efficiency of the class B operation is much higher than the class A operation. But efficiency is more in class B operation. So push pull class B amplifiers. Okay, so this is the class B. To get the full cycle, in this push-pull circuit requires two transformers. In this push-pull class B amplifiers, there are two transformers. One as the input transformer, that is the driver transformer. So one is the driver transformer and another transformer is the output transformer. Okay. So for two transformers are used. First transformer is driver transformer and second transformer is the output transformer. Okay. And the input signal is applied to the primary of the driver circuit, driver transformer. So input is applied, driver transformer. Both the transformers are center tapped. This is the center tapping. Both the transformers are center tapping. So the push-pull class B amplifiers is this one. Two transistors and also two transformers. Okay, this is the load. So only 180 degrees is produced in class B amplifiers. Both the transistors are in same. Okay. So in this circuit, both the Q1 and Q2 transistors are of NPN type. Both the transistors are in NPN type. So the circuit can use both the Q1 and Q2 of the PNP type. In such case, only change is that supply voltage. In NPN, supply voltage is positive VCC, and in PNP transistors, supply voltage is the negative voltage, that means minus VCC. So the basic circuit remains the same in both the NPN and PNP. So generally the circuit using the NPN transistors are used. Mainly NPN transistors are used. Both the transistors are in common emitter configuration. Okay, mainly any operation, mainly CE configuration is used. The driver transformer drives the circuit. Okay, driver transformer is the input transformer. So driver transformer drives the circuit. The input signal is applied to the primary of the driver transformer. The center tap of the secondary of the driver transformer is grounded. So driver transformer center tap is the grounded. This is the grounded. Okay. The center tap on the primary of the output transformer is connected to the supply. So that is the positive VCC. So this is the positive VCC supply. So the supply VCC, the center tap on the primary of the output transformer is connected to the supply VCC. So with respect to the center tap, the positive of cycle of the input signal at point A, this is the at point A shown on the secondary of the driver transformer. Okay, and driver transformer will be positive while the point B will be negative. So this is the positive at point A. At point A is positive. At point B there will be negative. Thus the voltages in the two halves of the secondary of the driver transformer will be equal to the opposite polarity. So hence the input signals applied to the base of the transistors Q1 and Q2 will be 180 degrees out of phase. Both are in out of phase. So this is the positive and this is the negative. So these two are the out of phase. Q1 and Q2 will be in the out of phase. The transistors Q1 conducts for the positive half cycle of the input, producing positive half cycle across the load. While the transistor Q2 conducts for the negative half cycle of the input, producing the negative half cycles across the load. Okay, thus across the load we get full cycle of the full input cycle. when at point A is positive, the transistor Q1 gets driven into the active region, while in the Q2 is in the cutoff region. Q1 is the at point A. So at point A, A is positive, Q1 is the active region, at point B is negative, so Q2 is the cutoff region. Okay. When point A is negative, at point B is positive, hence the transistor Q2 gets driven into the active region. Both are reverse. B is positive, A is negative, so B is active region, A is cutoff region. That means Q1 is the cutoff region, Q2 is the active region. Okay. So this is the DC power output, AC power input, AC output power efficiency. So DC power. Power means voltage into current. So VCC into IDC. IDC means 2IM by pi. So P input AC equal to 2IM by pi VCC. And AC power output. That means AC means RMS value. So VRMS into IRMS. RMS means root mean square value. Okay. So PAC equal to V square M by 2 RL. And efficiency. Efficiency is the PAC by PDC into 100. Percentage of efficiency. So that is equal to 78.5%. And total harmonic distortion. So total harmonic distortion D equal to percentage of D equal to odd square root of D square, D3 square plus D5 square plus D7 square. All are in odd. Already we tell crossover distortion. Okay. And the next one. Complementary symmetry push-pull class B power amplifier. So main difference of push-pull and complementary symmetry push-pull power amplifier is both the transistors. Okay. In push-pull power amplifiers, both the transistors are in NPN type, and complementary symmetry is the one transistor is NPN and another transistor is PNP transistor. Okay. So in this so instead of using same type of transistors NPN or PNP, one NPN and another PNP is used in complementary and symmetry. Okay, one PNP and one NPN transistors. So the amplifier circuit is called the complementary symmetry class B amplifier. So the circuit is transformer less circuit. So there is no transformers. There is no bulky. But with the common emitter configuration, it becomes difficult to match the output impedance of the maximum power transfer without an output transformers. Hence, the matched pair of complementary transistors are used in common collector configuration in this circuit. In addition, voltage feedback can be used to produce the output impedance for the matching. Okay. So Q1 is NPN and Q2 is the PNP type. In the positive off cycle of the input signal, the transistor Q1 gets driven into active region and starts conducting. The same signal gets amplified to the base of the Q2. But as it is complementary type, remains in off condition. During positive off cycle, this result into positive off cycle across the load RL. So during the negative off cycle of the signal, the transistor Q2 is PNP, Q2 being PNP gets biased into the conduction, while the transistor Q1 gets driven into the cutoff region. So QT is conducting, Q1 is the cutoff region. Hence Q2 conducts during negative off cycle of the input, producing negative off cycles across the load RL. Thus, for the complementary cycle, complete cycle of the input, the complete cycle of the output signal is developed across the load. Okay. And the next one is the class AB amplifiers. So in this complementary symmetry, advantages are: due to common collector configuration, impedance matching is possible. Okay, and frequency response improves due to transformer-less class B amplifier circuit. These are all the advantages of the class B complementary symmetry push-pull amplifiers. Okay, and the next one, class AB amplifiers. So in this class AB amplifiers, the Q point is above the x-axis, above the x-axis, but below the midpoint on the load line. The output signal is obtained for the more than the 180 degrees but less than the 360 degrees. In class A, 360 degrees. In class B, 180 degrees. In class AB, output signal is maximum more than 180 degrees but less than the 360 degrees. Okay, so output signal is distorted in class AB operation. The efficiency is more than the class A but less than the class B. The class AB operation is use it to eliminate the crossover distortion. Okay, that is the class AB amplifiers. So in this circuit, class AB amplifier, two transistors are used. So in this, also two transformers are used, both are in center tap. Okay, so this is the circuit diagram. In this also the crossover distortion is caused by the nonlinear transistors characteristics. Okay, so it can be eliminated by using class AB push-pull amplifiers. So to minimize the crossover distortion, a small standby circuit current flows at zero excitation. The voltage drop across the resistance is adjusted to the approximately equal to the VR, cut-in voltage. VR means cut-in voltage. Thus AB, class AB operation results in less distortion than the class B. Okay, so and the next one, heat sink. So the transistors handling small signals. So in this, the heat is developed. The maximum power handled by the particular power transistor. Okay, and the temperature of the transistor junctions are closely related. So this is because of the fact that the junction temperature increases due to power dissipation. Okay, this is the main point. Due to power dissipation, the temperature is increases. So the collector dissipation can be PD equal to VCE into IC. Okay, so the heat sink is the mechanical device. So which is connected or press fit into the case of the transistor that provides the large surface area to dissipate the developed heat. The heat sinks carries the heat to the surroundings. The important advantages of the heat sinks are the temperature of the case gets lowered. The power handling capacity of the transistors can approach the related maximum value. Okay, so that is the heat sinks. Okay, so thermal stability. So to avoid the thermal runaway, the required condition is that the rate at which the heat is released at the collector junction must be exceed the rate at which the heat cannot be dissipated under the steady state condition. So thermal stability. Stability means constant. So thermal runaway is high temperature. So to avoid the thermal runaway, the required condition is the rate of the heat is released at the collector junction must not exceed the rate which heat cannot dissipate it under the steady state condition. Okay, that is the dou P. See, by dou P tau is less than the dou P D by dou P J. So that is the condition. Tomorrow we will discuss the Churud amplifiers. Okay.